It's time to play Family Feud. All returning champs, the Hermosillo family, playing against the Brooks family. Now, here's the star of our show, the remarkable Richard Cox!
All right, let's get this party started. Thank you, and welcome back to the Family Feud. We have returning for their third time, the Hermosillo family. Kathy.
Ricardo.
Three's a charm.
Oh. Yes, it is.
Muchas gracias.
De nada.
Introduce me to la familia.
Familia.
I'm very good at this.
Cousin, this is my cousin Leslie. This is my nephew Jeremy, my lovable husband Daniel, and my sister-in-law Tina.
Yeah. All right. And they are playing against the Brooks family. Yeah. Debbie, how are you?
Very well, thank you.
All right, well, introduce me to your family.
Thank you. My name's Debbie. I've brought my youngest son with me, James, my oldest son, Nathan, my brother, Cecil, and my wonderful husband, Mike.
All right. The guys.
Yeah.
Are you ready to play?
We are so ready to play.
Are you ready, Kathy?
I'm ready.
Let's play the feud, Debbie and Kathy. All right, good luck, you guys. We surveyed 100 people. Top 6 answers are on my board. Give me the most popular answer. If gas gets much more expensive, name something you may have to go without. Kathy.
A bicycle.
You may have to go without a bicycle.
Might have to go without driving.
Without driving. Okay, they're gonna play. All right, James.
Yes, sir.
What is something you may have to go without if gas gets more expensive?
I'm gonna have to say work.
Yeah. Can't get to a job without a car.
Good answer, James. Good answer, James.
Okay. You may have to go without work.
Yeah.
Go without work. That's all right, Nathan. What would you have to go without if gas gets more expensive?
I'm gonna have to say vacation.
A vacation.
Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
A vacation.
Yeah.
Travel. Everything gets affected. Cecil.
You know, if you're not driving your car, you don't need to pay for insurance. Insurance.
You may go good without answer. Insurance.
Good. Good answer.
So that's a good thing. Yeah. Insurance. I'm a Seal family, that's 2 strikes.
Come on, Mike.
Come on, Dad.
Okay.
All right, Mike.
I'm gonna say food.
Good answer.
You have to go without food.
You're not gonna be able to eat.
Good answer. Good answer.
Okay. All right, if that is there, it's kind of scary. But it's good for you because it'll be up there. But if it's not there, the Hermosillo family gets a chance to steal.
Let's see it.
We may have to go without food.
Yeah.
All right, Debbie.
Okay.
If gas gets more expensive, what are we gonna have to go without?
We're already there. Entertainment, movies.
Movies and entertainment.
Good answer.
Yeah.
Good answer.
Cut it out. Out of the expenses. All right?
Yeah.
If it's there, you're still alive. And James, we come to you again.
All right.
Okay. All right? Going out to see the movies. Oh, boy. All right, what are we thinking?
I think heater, without a heater.
That may have to go without heat.
We're gonna go without heat.
Without heat.
Heat.
You know,
gas
to heat up the oil,
thing. Yep.
All those things, heating, so. Just, you know, wear more sweaters.
Yeah, blankets.
Blankets. Okay, if it's there, you guys stole the points from the Brooks family, taking first blood in this battle. Going out without heat. Yeah. Yeah. Number 3.
No clothes.
And number 6.
Cigarette smoking.
All right. James and Leslie. First team to 300 points gets that shot at $20,000. Top five answers are on the board. If you could miraculously become boss at work, what's the first thing you'd do? James.
Increase my salary.
Give yourself a raise.
Yes. Yes.
All right, they're playing. There you go. Nathan.
Repeat the question for me, please.
If you could miraculously become boss at work, what's the first thing you'd do?
Make my lunch hour longer.
There you go. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer. Good answer.
Give yourself a longer lunch.
Yeah.
Cecil.
How about give all my friends raises?
Good
well,
answer.
Well, that's all part of okay. Give raises.
Okay.
Okay.
You're giving everybody a raise.
I'm giving everybody a raise. How about
3 seconds?
Open.
All right, Mike, you're the boss. You're the boss at work. What would you do?
I'd give myself more vacation time.
Give yourself more vacation.
Good answer.
More vacation. There you go. All right, Debbie.
I think I would reduce the workload.
Reduce
the workload.
Workload.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Lighten up the
good
workload.
Answer.
Okay.
Good answer. Yeah. Good answer.
Lighten up the workload. And the seals, that's two strikes.
Okay.
All right, James.
I'm going to have to say not work on the weekends.
Not work on the weekends.
Yeah.
Good answer.
All
right.
Okay. And it's there, Nathan, I'm coming to you. Otherwise, the Hermosillos get a chance to steal. No more working on the weekends.
Yes.
Yes. Come on, you can do it.
Come on, Nathan.
Nathan.
I'm going to have to say change the benefits, insurance, all that kind
there
of stuff.
There we go. Good benefits. Answer.
Change
good
benefits.
Answer.
Benefits.
Good answer. Excellent. Good answer. Good answer.
Change benefits.
Fire some people
you don't like.
Yep, that's what we're going to do.
That's right. Because if you miraculously become the boss, where's the boss?
Yeah.
He's being fired. If it's there, once again, you stole the points and kept the Brooks family at zero. But if it's not there, they keep those points. Fire some people. The Hermosillo family at 147. The Brooks family at zero, but our goal is 300 points. Don't go away. Come on back. Oh, you know, if I were the boss, I wouldn't fire you. I'd hire you. Come on back. Welcome back to the Family Feud. The Hermosillo family at 147. The Brooks family at zero. Nathan, Jeremy. Shake hands, good luck. Somebody's at zero, so I'm doubling the points. Just the kind of guy I am. Top five answers on the board. We asked 100 women. Name an animal some men look like when they dance.
Monkey.
A monkey! Right back. All right, they're playing.
How are you, Betsy? Welcome to the show. You are a lovely young woman. And let me just get my hand up there and feel that one. And that one. And we're looking for something you shop for at the mall. 3 seconds.
Well, 100 women were asked, an animal men look like when they dance.
I'm going to say a tiger.
A tiger.
A tiger.
Couchy.
That's right. That's right.
A tiger.
Good answer.
Tina.
Chicken.
A chicken.
Chicken.
There you go.
A chicken.
Gabby.
people look like a duck.
A duck.
A duck.
Okay. Quack, quack. A duck. Two strikes, Brooke family.
Okay.
Lizard.
I'm gonna say they look sly, like a lizard.
A lizard.
Sly, a lizard.
That's what I thought of. Good answer, good answer, good answer.
Okay.
That's the way she dances.
If that's there, you're still alive. Jeremy, you keep thinking.
I'm thinking.
Are you thinking?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Okay. We're looking for here, lizard, lizard, lizard.
Penguin.
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 Snake.
Penguin.
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 Richard, we're going to go with a penguin.
The penguin?
Yes.
See it.
All right. What does that look like?
I would. Yeah.
That's the penguin dance? Okay.
See it.
As Burgess Meredith.
Yeah.
It's going back a ways. Okay. If it's there, you guys finally got those points that you needed. We're looking for penguin. What's number two?
Bear.
Bear. Three. What does that look like? What's number four? Drew. All right. The Hermosillo family at 251. The Brooks family still at zero, but it's anyone's game. We'll be right back. Don't go away. What does an elephant look like dancing? I have no idea.
Closed captioning is sponsored in part by...
Welcome back to the Family Feud. The Hermosillo family at 251. The Brooks family at zero. Cecil, Daniel. All right. It's okay. I'm tripling the points.
Yeah!
Get this party started. But I'm only going to read this once, all right? So Mike, Tina, everybody, listen closely. Top four answers on the board. Besides buying it, name a way someone can get...
Lease it.
Name a way someone can get a car.
Yeah.
Lease it. One answer better.
Rent it.
Rent it.
All right.
Player pass. All right, they're playing. All right, Mike.
I'm going to say as a gift.
They get it as a gift.
Nice. Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
I like the way you think. Get it.
Steal it.
Good answer.
Not that I would do that.
They steal it. Number one. All right, James.
I'm gonna go out on a limb on this one and say, borrow it.
Yeah!
Good answer.
It's a good limb. Hey, hey, that is a good, strong limb.
It is a limb.
Borrow it. Oh. Two strikes from the
CFM.
I'm gonna
go with, win it.
They win
there
it!
Go. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Again, if it's there, you guys, get some well-needed points.
Let's see a move. Come on, let's see a move.
We go to sudden death. Otherwise, it's their third strike, and they get a chance to win. Win it!
Yeah!
No one reached 300 points, so we're going to sudden death. Mike and Tina. Good job, you guys. For this survey, we only want the number one answer. The top answer will get you enough points to win the game for your family. Are you ready?
Ready.
Name something that might be on the rocks. Tina.
A bug.
A bug. Mike.
Scotch.
Scotch. Yes!
So close. So close.
Come on.
That was tough. It could be a marriage.
I know. Come on. We will be back to play Fast Money right after this. Do not go away. The Brooks family won the game, and now they're playing Fast Money for a shot at $20,000. Now you have Cecil off stage where he can't see or hear your answers. I'll ask you 5 questions in 20 seconds. Give me the most popular answer.
Okay.
If you can't think of something, say pass, and we'll come back to it. Now, if you and Cecil together get 200 points, you will win
$20,000!
Are you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Time will start after I read the first question. Name something people make reservations for.
Dinner.
Something kids draw pictures of.
Their family.
A color M&Ms come in.
Red.
Something kept on an airplane for emergencies.
Pass.
The latest time it's still okay to call someone on the phone.
9 o'clock.
Something kept on an airplane for emergencies.
Fire extinguisher.
Fire extinguisher. You made it. All right. Something that people make reservations for, you said. Dinner. Survey said.
Yeah.
That's the way to start. Something the kids draw pictures of. You said. Their family. Survey said.
Yeah!
Wow. How about a color that M&Ms come in? You said. Red. Survey said.
Yeah!
Holy smokes.
My favorite color.
I can see. You're on fire. Something kept on an airplane for emergencies. You said. A fire extinguisher. Survey said. How about the latest time it's still okay to call someone on the phone? You said 9 p.m. Survey said.
Yeah!
Wow. Yeah! Clear the board. Yeah! We will bring out Cecil. That's good. That's good. All right, Cecil. Debbie got you 145 points.
Wow.
You still need 55 points. I'll ask you the same 5 questions. You can't duplicate the answer. If you do, you'll hear this sound. I will say try again, and you give me a different answer.
Okay.
It is tougher, so we'll give you 25 seconds.
Okay.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Remind everyone of Debbie's answers. 25 seconds on the clock. Time will start after I read the first question. Name something people make reservations for.
Airline.
Something kids draw pictures of.
Parents.
Try again.
Trees.
A color M&Ms come in.
Red.
Try again.
Green.
Something kept on an airplane for emergencies.
Life jacket.
The latest time it's still okay to call someone on the phone.
11 o'clock.
Good answer.
Good job. Good job.
All right. Good job. Let's see how you did. Something that people make reservations for, you said. Airline reservations. Survey said.
Yeah!
Hotel reservations, number one. Something kids draw pictures of. You said, trees. Survey said, eight.
All right, there you go, there you go.
What color M&Ms come in? You said, green. Yeah, you gotta look out for those green ones.
They taste the best.
Do they? You need 16 points. Survey said, red was number one. Families, pictures of families, air mask and oxygen, and 9 p.m. And that's $20,000. And they're coming back tomorrow to fight off another family for another shot. I'm Richard Karn. This is the Family Feud. And you're coming back tomorrow. I'll be waiting for you.
I am the champion. I am the champion. No time for losers, 'cause I am the champion of the world.
Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise, playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing,
we will rock you. We will rock you.
Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street, gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face, a big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place. Somebody better put your bag into your place.
We will rock you.
Sing it.
We will rock you.
Everybody,
we will rock you. We are the champions.
$20,000.
It's time to play Family Feud. Our returning champs, the Brooks family, playing against the Mercado family. Now here's the star of our show, the sexy scoundrel, Richard Kemp.
All right. Thank you. Thank you very much, and welcome back to the Family Feud. We have returning for their second time with, $20,000, the Brooks family. Debbie, welcome back.
Thank you.
And
nice
congratulations.
Thank you so much.
All right. Well, introduce us once again to the family.
I'm Debbie, and I am a blessed woman with four wonderful men in my life that I brought here today. My youngest son, James, my oldest son, Nathan, my brother, Cecil, and my husband, Mike.
Okay. And they are playing against the Mercado family.
You too, huh?
Romeo.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
Good, good, good.
Okay, well, introduce me to your family.
Okay, I have my cousin here, Jocelyn. I have another cousin, Eric. Another cousin, Abigail. And my uncle, Ray, Crazy Ray.
Yeah. Uncle Ray. All cousins. Are you ready to play?
I'm ready.
Are you ready to play?
Yeah.
Let's play the feud. Yeah. Debbie and Romeo. All right, good luck, you guys. We went out, we surveyed 100 people. Top five answers are on my board. Give me the most popular answer. Name one thing about a vacation that costs the most money. Romeo.
Food.
Food. Two answers better than that, Debbie.
Airfare.
Airfare. Claire Pat.
We're gonna play.
All right, they're playing. They're playing. Okay, and the food on the airplane. That costs you in different ways. All right, James.
I'm gonna have to go with hotel.
Good answer.
The hotel.
Good
Show me the hotel. There you go, Nathan. What is the one thing about a vacation that costs the most money?
I'm gonna have to go with, it's not the most, but car rental.
Car rental.
Good answer, good answer, good answer.
Car rental. There you go. Hey, your vacation could be driving.
Yeah.
You know, you might be driving along. Cecil.
My wife will agree with me. I have to buy every souvenir.
Good answer. All right, where'd you buy that tie?
I bought it in Canada.
There you go. If it's there, you swept the board. If not, it's your first strike.
Okay.
Souvenirs. That was quick. James and Jocelyn. Man, you're good. First team to 300 points, though, gets that shot at $20,000. All right. Top eight answers are on the board. Tell me something of yours that you swear is possessed. James.
My dog.
The dog. Two answers better than that.
My furniture.
The spooky furniture. Claire Pat. Okay, they're playing. They're playing. All right, Nathan. Something of yours you swear is possessed.
I've had some crummy cars. I'm going to have to say my car.
There you go.
They made a movie about that car, didn't they? They sure did. Your car. All right, Cecil.
How about your TV?
The TV.
Good answer.
You know, the subliminal images coming through there. The TV. Oh! Something of yours that you swear is possessed.
I'm gonna say the house.
Good answer.
Great answer.
Weird noises sometimes at night.
Creaking.
Yep.
Here and there. The house. There you go. All right, Debbie.
Not that I think my family is, but some family members.
Some family members.
Go. Brothers,
good answer.
Sisters.
Good answer. Good answer.
Ooh, be more specific.
Okay. How about siblings?
Siblings, brothers, sisters.
There you go. Yeah. There you go.
All right. Your siblings. Oh, that's two strikes for Carlos. All right, Jane.
You got it.
Can you repeat something the question?
Something of yours that you would swear was possessed.
I'm gonna say the VCR.
The VCR.
That's okay. Get in. Get in. Get in. Get in.
I swear I set that clock. Power went out, something like that. If it's there, you're still alive. And Nathan, I'm coming to you. Otherwise, the Mercados get a chance to steal these points from you. The VCR. I got refrigerator. That's the only thing I'm hearing.
You heard it. Refrigerator.
Refrigerator.
That's right. You like that?
It's weird how it can come on. You know, it'll be all quiet, and then all of a sudden you hear this.
Yes.
Just the right time.
I felt
it. It's making ice. Like, remember me? Okay, if it's there, you guys stole those points from the Brooks. We're looking for the refrigerator. Oh! Oh! We left a lot up there. The number one answer, what do you think it is? As opposed to your brothers and sisters. Five. Number six.
Myself.
Are you really yourself? Number seven.
Cell phone.
And number eight.
Cell phone.
Ah. The Brooks family at 131. The Mercados at zero, but our goal is 300 points. Don't go away. We are possessed. We are possessed with a really good show coming up. So come on back. Welcome back to the Family Feud. The Brooks family at 131. The Mercados at zero. Nathan and Eric. Okay, you know what? I don't know what's possessing me, but I'm doubling the points. It's still anybody's game. Top six answers on the board. Name a college a good football player would want to go to.
USC.
USC. Yeah. Four answers better than that, Nathan.
Notre Dame.
Notre Dame.
Woo! They're playing.
Okay, they're playing. You know, is it Notre Dame or is it Notre Dame?
It all depends on where you're from.
Depends on where you're from. Notre Dame, Notre Dame. One sounds classier, I guess. Cecil.
If I was 3 inches taller and 75 pounds more, I'd play for University of Michigan.
Michigan. I wish I were in Michigan. Go Blue. All right, Mike.
I'm going to say UCLA.
UCLA.
Good answer. Good answer.
UCLA. Yeah. All right, Debbie.
I may live with a lot of men, but I don't know about my football. I'm going to go with University of Miami.
Good University answer. Of Miami.
Good answer. Good answer.
University of Miami.
Yeah. Woo. Good job. Thank you.
James,
you
if you were a good football player, where would you want to go?
Ohio State.
Ohio.
Good answer.
Good answer. Good answer.
A Buckeye. It's a Buckeye. You know, it's like a nut. It's a nut. It's an acorn. All right, if it's there, though, that's not so nutty. You've swept the board. Otherwise, it's your first strike. We're looking for Ohio. It's only one strike. Nathan, another college football pantheon.
I'm going to have to go with Kansas. Kansas State.
Kansas? Well, that's two different ones, so you're going with Kansas.
Yeah.
All right. Because there's Kansas and Kansas State.
Yes, sir.
So, if it's there, You swept the board, otherwise it's your second strike and Cecil will come down to you. We're looking for Kansas. It's all right. Not in Kansas anymore. Cecil, a good football player would want to go where?
If Michigan turned me down, I'd go to Florida State.
Florida State. All right. If the Noles are up there, you guys swept the board, take all the points, keep them at zero. Otherwise, they get a chance to steal. We're looking for Florida State Seminole. Yeah! Boy, they are tough. 269 to zero, but it's still anybody's game. They could come back. Look what happened last week in college football. We'll be right back. You stay tuned.
Closed captioning is sponsored in part by...
Welcome back to the Family Feud. We have the Brooks family at 269. We have the Mercados at zero. Cecil and Abigail. Okay, I doubled the points. But now I've got to triple them. Who knows where I have to go next? Top four answers are on the board, but I'm only reading this once. All right, you'll only hear this question once, so listen up. Name a country that seems to tell other countries what to do. Cecil.
Good old United States.
The U.S. of A. Square pass.
We're going to play.
All right, they're going to play. All right, Mike.
I'm going to say England.
Good answer.
England. I think they used to.
Richard, I'm going to go with France.
France.
Yes, good answer. France.
France. James.
Let's go with Italy.
Good answer.
Italy. Mercados, that's two strikes. All right, Nathan.
Up until recently, I'd have to say Iraq. They had their fingers in some other countries.
Okay. Okay. All right. Iraq. Yeah! All right. All right, Cecil.
Well, they have the most people, so there's a lot of people to tell them what to do. How about China?
Good answer. If China's there, you guys as a team have taken all the points. Yeah. If it's not there, though, it's your third strike, and the Mercados can slip back into this game. We want to see China. All right, here's your chance, Mercados.
Japan.
I think they're only giving you one answer.
That's what I gotta go with. Japan.
You're going with Japan.
Going with Japan.
Good answer. Very small Japan.
It's all right.
Very large China. A country that seems to tell other countries what to do. It's always the little guy, isn't it?
That's right.
If it's there, you guys are back in this game, we go to sudden death. We're looking for Japan. Oh, smokes! Number four. Thank you, guys. You guys were good. I mean, you really were. And it just wasn't there for you. Who's playing? Good job. We will be back to play Fast Money right after this. Don't go away. Once again, the Brooks family won the game, and now they're playing Fast Money for another $20,000. Now, you have Cecil off stage where he can't see or hear your answers. I'll ask you five questions in 20 seconds. Give me the most popular answer.
Okay.
If you can't think of something, say pass. We'll come back to it if there's time left.
Okay.
Now, if you and Cecil together get 200 points, you will win...
$20,000!
Are you ready?
Yes.
20 seconds on the clock, please. Clock will start after I read the first question. How many nights in a row could you eat pizza before you got sick of it?
Two.
A word that rhymes with dunk.
Monk.
A flavor of hard candy.
Jolly Rancher.
Oh. Something a sailor has to worry about crashing into.
Pass.
Something a dog is likely to do when it first meets you.
Bark.
Something a sailor has to worry about crashing into.
Other boats.
Ooh. Good job.
Thank you.
Good job. All right. How many nights in a row could you eat pizza before you got sick of it? You said two nights. Survey said. Good job on the board. A word that rhymes with dunk. You said monk. Survey said.
It's okay.
I like that word. A flavor of hard candy. You said a happy rancher. What do ranchers taste like? A lot of dust on them. Survey said. I knew where you were going with that. Something a sailor has to worry about crashing into, you said. Other boats? Well, yes, they do.
Yeah.
Survey said 19.
Okay.
That's better. Okay. Something that a dog is likely to do when it meets you, you said, say hello. He's barking, he's just saying hello.
Yeah.
Survey said 20.
All right, good. Thank you.
Clear the board. We will bring out Cecil. All right. Debbie got you 66 points.
Okay.
You need 134.
You can do it.
I'll ask you the same five questions. You can't duplicate the answer. If you do, you'll hear this. I'll say try again. You give me a different answer.
Okay.
It's tougher, so we'll give you 25 seconds.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yes.
All right. Remind everyone of Debbie's answers. 25 seconds on the clock. Time will start after I read the first question. How many nights in a row could you eat pizza before you got sick of it?
Four.
A word that rhymes with dunk.
Punk.
A flavor of hard candy.
Lifesaver. Cherry.
Something a sailor has to worry about crashing into.
Rocks.
Something a dog is likely to do when it first meets you.
Sniff.
Good job.
Good job.
All right.
Good job. Good answer.
All right.
Good work.
How many nights in a row can you eat pizza before you got sick of it? You said 4 nights a week. That's more than half. Survey said 5.
Okay.
Well, 2
okay.
is number 1.
It's okay.
2 nights. A word that rhymes with dunk. You said punk. Survey said 14.
Okay.
All right. Sunk. Sunk was number 1. A flavor of hard candy. You said cherry. My favorite flavor. Survey said 12.
Okay.
Peppermint. Peppermint was number 1. Something a sailor has to worry about crashing into. You said rocks. Survey said 29.
Yeah. Yeah.
Much better. Number 1 was iceberg. Just kind of a frozen rock. Something a dog is likely to do when it first meets you. You said sniffs you. You need 74 points. Survey said.
All right.
Okay.
All right. Sniff was number 1. Well, we're giving you $5 a point for $800 and a 2-day total of $20,800. And they're coming back next show for another chance at $20,000. I'm Richard Karn. This is Family Feud, and we'll see you next time right here.